entertainment bullseye every week with her, Hard Riding. Straight shooting.
Around here, mister. You sure you got the right place?
I'm sure this is the place.
I know it's none of my business, but...
That's right. It's none of your business, Charlie.
Hey, how come you know my name?
You don't recognize me, do you?
No, can't say as I do.
9 years in prison can change a man in more ways than one.
9 years in... Well, you're Dobie Larson.
That's right. I've come back to pay off a few old debts. We'll see you, Charlie.
Shoot, baby.
All right, stay right where you are.
Hey, what's the big idea?
What are you snooping around here for?
Well, I wasn't snooping. I was picking berries and saw you in here and wondered what you're doing. All I did is got sort of curious.
I call that snooping. Now, come on in here. What's the matter? You deaf or something? Hurry up. Come on back here.
After you.
Crazy female, you could have killed me shooting like that.
Well, if I ever do kill anyone, it'll be a man that's beating up a kid.
I didn't do anything to him.
He pulled a gun on me.
Pulled a gun on you?
I'll do it to anybody else that trespasses on my property.
Your property? Are you Dobie Larson?
That's right. Now you take this kid and clear out of here.
Wait a minute. I'm Annie Oakley. I'm sorry I took those shots at you. Well, it wasn't a very nice way to welcome you home.
That's about all I could expect from Luke MacTavish's niece.
Then you remember me.
I remember that it was your uncle that arrested me.
You know, if you'd get that overgrown chip off your shoulder, you'd sure get along a lot better.
I didn't come back to get along.
Then why did you come back?
I came back to settle a few old scores.
Look, I don't blame you for being...
Don't blame me. 9 years in prison for something I didn't do, and you don't blame me for getting sore? My mother left to die in that miserable shack, and you think I got a chip on my shoulder?
I'm terribly sorry about your mom, but it wasn't anyone's fault.
I say it was, and I'm going to get even with this town for what they did to Mom and me. And I don't need any advice, help, or company.
Well, you can't fight the whole town single-handed.
Oh, you're wrong, sister. Dead wrong.
Oh, for Pete's sakes, be reasonable. I can't arrest a man until he's committed a crime. So far, all Dobie's done is come back to his own house and mind his own business.
He's been threatening us, hasn't he?
He hasn't made a definite threat against any of you.
Every time I see him, he mentions that I was foreman of the juror that sent him away.
Well, it's true, isn't it?
Yeah, but when he says it, it's a threat.
Sheriff Mike was here, he'd do something.
Uncle Luke wouldn't do any more than Lofty's done.
Well, that isn't enough. We don't need a deputy sheriff to take care of Lawson. We'll do it ourselves.
Come on. Hold it, Bronk. I don't like talk like that.
Well, that's too bad.
Wait a minute. There'll be no rail ridings or lynchings while I'm in office. You understand that, Bronk?
Who said anything about a lynching?
Well, that's more like it. I suppose you'd lead Dobie to me. I don't think you'll start anything.
You'd better not.
I handled that situation pretty well, don't you think?
You did all right.
All right. Is that all you can say? I thought it took some doing.
If I said any more, your head would swell up and bust.
Oh, Annie.
Well, how'd it go?
It won't go for a lynching. You'll have to think of something else.
I knew you'd botch the lynching.
Quit riding me, Eli. What are you going to do?
Well, there's a shipment of money coming in on one of my stages the first thing in the morning. We're going to arrange a holdup.
You're crazy. We can't risk another frame.
Worked pretty well the first time, didn't it?
Dobie was young then. He's a lot smarter now.
Yeah. You know, it's kind of funny at that. First time we framed him gave me enough money to buy the stage line. This second frame-up's going to keep the line going.
What do you mean?
The Gorham line is about broke. We need that money that Larson's going to steal for us.
Still think it's too risky?
Oh, shut up and listen. Here's a coat, just like the one that Dobie wears. All you have to do is to put it on.
Strong box.
Yes, sir.
All right, get going and don't bother to look back.
Yes, sir. Get up! Dobie Larson.
Are you sure?
Sure, I recognize his voice. You know how he talks.
It's a mighty serious charge. Are you positive?
Well, it wasn't just his voice, Miss Annie. It was his build, his clothes, everything about him. It was Larson, all right. There's no doubt about it.
Eli, round up some of the boys and ride out to the canyon and try to pick up his trail.
Where are you going?
I'll take his cabin and join you later.
Oh, wait a minute, Lofty. I'm going with you.
I don't suppose it would do any good to say that you can't come with me. That it's too dangerous? That you'd just be in my way?
None at all. You know you can't get along without me.
Bet you like to try. Just once.
Horse?
Yeah, he bought it from Hank Lewis.
I told you I didn't want any company.
This is official business.
Step straight back into the house and don't try any tricks.
All right, now drop your gun belt.
You mind telling me what this is all about?
Somebody held up the stage from Wickford about an hour ago.
What's that got to do with me?
Well, Charlie Baker, the driver, identified you as the bandit.
It's crazy. I've been here all morning.
Can you prove that?
Nobody else has been here but me.
Well, it's just your word against Charlie's then.
And my word isn't any good around here, is that it?
Nobody said that.
No, but that's what you're thinking. Am I under arrest?
Well, for the time being, let's just say you're being held for questioning.
Well, I guess I better get dressed, huh?
Where are you going?
My shirt is on a line out in front.
Stay here. We'll get it for you. You mind, Annie?
As long as you don't ask me to iron it for him.
You aren't taking many chances, are you?
Uh-uh. After 9 years in prison, you must know every trick in the book.
Well, if I'm so smart, how come I couldn't pull a simple little holdup without being recognized?
I don't know.
Well, think it over. And while you're thinking...
You guys alone.
You kind of caught me off guard.
I kind of figured that.
All right. Don't rub it in.
I don't have to. You know you can't get along without me. Come on, let's get this guy back to town.
I've said all I'm going to say, and I've said it 20 times before. Now leave me alone.
Things will go easier if you tell me where you hid the money.
All right. Do it the hard way.
Any luck?
That's like talking to a deaf mule.
Lofty, I've been thinking. Suppose this is a frame?
That's been bothering you too, huh?
Yes. Anyone that would pull a holdup without changing their clothes or disguising their voice is too dumb to live. And Dobie isn't dumb.
Yeah, that's why I've got to find that stolen money. Look after things here, will you?
Sure. Oh, Lofty, if you see Tagg, will you tell him no pie tonight unless he brings me some berries?
I'll tell him.
Thanks.
A
I'll meet you out at the house.
Who's out there?
Dobie, I believe you're innocent, but the town will never think so. About your only chance is to make a break for it. You'll find a wagon waiting back at the jail. A friend.
What's at the service in this joint?
What do you want?
How about some water?
I guess that can be arranged.
Don't make a sound. Unlock this door.
Where'd you get that gun?
Never mind that.
You know, if you shoot that thing, that everybody in town will hear it?
I'll take that chance. I mean it, Annie. Unlock this door.
And I was just beginning to think you didn't rob that stage.
I didn't. Now get over and get those keys.
You're so innocent, and why are you pulling such a stunt as this?
You people sent me to prison once before for something I didn't do. But you're not going to get that chance again. Now get in there.
It won't work, Dobie. Believe me, it won't.
Turn around. Put your hands behind you. Hold it, Dobie. Get those hands up. What kind of double cross is this?
Shut up and drop the gun. That's better. From now on, if you do as you're told, you... Yeah, I guess you could call it that.
Well, how'd he escape?
I don't know. Help me get him in the wagon.
Why don't you just carry him back to jail?
Because he's not going back to jail.
Huh?
I'm taking him someplace else. And seeing you know so much, you're going along with him.
Yeah, but Mr. Brock, I...
And if you know what's good for you, you'll keep your mouth shut. Now help me get him in the wagon.
Got into a fight. Somebody must have tried to stop him.
Lofty, this is Tagg's bucket, don't you see? He was bringing these berries home for supper. That means he was here during the fight. He must have run into Dobie, and Dobie forced him to go with him. Lofty, what are we going to do?
We'll go after him. I'll deputize every man in town. We'll turn this territory inside out. But don't worry, Annie. We'll fight him.
Today's holdup was just a beginning, Dobie. Now that you broke out of jail, you're going to become a regular Billy the Kid. Hold up stages, rob banks...
Pin one hold up on me, pin a dozen of them. I don't care. What about the kid?
Well, now that he's mixed up in this, he's going to have to stay with us. I've got a nice soundproof room behind that bookcase for the two of you. Show it to him, Bronk. The Spanish gent that built this house had some funny ideas about a lot of things.
I didn't mean it that way. All I want to know is what happens to Tagg when you're through with me.
Oh, we'll figure something out. In the meantime, he's going to be useful to us.
How do you mean that?
Well, I want you to write a letter to Lofty Craig and tell him to call his posse in, or Tagg here will get hurt.
In other words, you want it to look like I was the one that snatched him, huh?
That's right.
Don't do it, Dobie. A letter like that'd scare Annie half to death.
Don't worry, kid. If you want a letter like that, you're going to have to write it yourself.
Dobie, my spelling's not very good. So let me put it this way. If you don't write the letter, Tagg here will get hurt for sure.
You do.
Here. Write down what I tell you.
Can't be as bad as that, Annie. It doesn't make sense for Dobie to hurt the kid.
Well, he's gotten far enough away by now. Why hasn't he let him go?
Maybe he has.
Well, then why haven't we found him? You've got 20 men out looking for him, haven't you?
It's dark now, Annie. Maybe Dobie's got him tied up someplace, or maybe...
Lofty!
What's that?
It's from Dobie.
Tagg is alive and all right. But if you want to see him again, call in your posse.
Well, that no good varmint. What did I tell you?
It's almost a relief. I mean, knowing so much better than uncertainty.
That skunk's hiding somewhere close. I guess all we can do is call in the boys. I'll get started in that.
Thanks, Lofty.
I'll fix some coffee.
Wait a minute. It's funny. Dobie misspelled his own name. There's no you in Larson.
What are you doing, Annie?
Well, I'm going to compare it with a form he filled out yesterday. He's writing, all right. Why would he deliberately misspell his own name unless he... Wait, look, Charlie, he's misspelled other words, too. He left the E off of alive, one of the L's out of all right, and the I out of again. E-L-I. Eli. Eli Gorham, that's what he's trying to say.
Well, what's Gorham got to do with it?
Well, I don't know, but I sure aim to find out. Locate Lofty and tell him I've gone to see Gorham. Where's Gorham?
In the living room, I guess, but what...
Turn around. All right, move.
What's going on here? Well, Annie, have you gone loco?
Maybe I have. Get over there.
Well, what's the gun for?
I'm aiming it. Right at you two.
Yes, I can see that.
Then maybe you can tell me where Tagg is.
Tagg? I don't know where he is. Have you seen him, Bronk?
Why, no. Not since a couple of days ago.
Annie, you must be under some sort of strain. Why don't you...
Where's Tagg?
He's not here. What makes you think he is?
Because of the letter that Dobie sent. The one with your name on it.
You're crazy. My name wasn't on that.
So you know about the letter.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know, it's a funny thing. I've never killed anybody in my life. But I've always wondered just how close I could come.
Annie, you're out of your head.
Maybe I am. But you better start praying. I'm still a good shot. I ought to be able to come closer than that. It's lucky you didn't move. That one could have been real messy.
Annie, stop it! Stop it!
You're going to tell me where my brother is.
All right, show her.
Annie!
Oh, Ted.
Annie, why don't you move now? Drop your gun, Annie, or the kid will get it first.
It's no use, Eli. I left word I was coming here.
Well, whoever's coming is going to be too late. Now get over here. Come on, Bronk, let's get out of here. Got here in time.
Lofty, did you shoot them both, Lofty?
Thanks, Lofty. I guess he kind of caught me off my guard.
Yeah, I kind of figured that.
Well, you don't have to rub it in.
Why should I? You know you can't get along without me.
You stay here, Charlie. I'll send you out some help.
Come on, Tagg. Let's us men go back to town.
You know, for once, I think I'll let him get in the last word.